termination. Only the last pair of chromosomes they are having the role in sex determination. We can write 44 plus XX. This is human female, and 44 plus XY is human male. When they form gametes, all the chromosomes which are homologous get separated. So 22 chromosomes will come in one gamete along with one from this 23rd pair. In the case of males, two types of gametes. One is 22 plus X, and the other one will be 22 plus Y. When a new zygote forms, again the condition get restored. 44 plus XX will be females. 44 plus XY. We can say the probability of having a female child is 50%, and a male child is 50%. This is said to be homologous, but they are not homologous because they are having different size. When you take human females, whereas they are having two homologous X chromosomes with same size and shape. In case of human males, they have X chromosome, larger one, and Y chromosome, a smaller one. Genes which are located on X chromosome as well as Y chromosome. And what would be their inheritance? Then we go for next generation. What would be the inheritance patterns of genes located on X chromosome as well as Y chromosome? This is sex-linked inheritance. Let us take an example.
Consider the genes present on X chromosome.
Then in the case of males, they do not have another allele on their Y chromosome because
Y chromosome is smaller than X chromosome.
Here itself you can see X chromosome ka jis portion mein ye gene hai uske counterpart Y chromosome mein nahi hai. So there is a special type of inheritance when they are on X chromosomes. Now look at the gene present on Y chromosome. What happened to Y chromosome?
The genes on the Y chromosome move from father to son, again to son, and again to son, like that.
That means from male, it goes to another male, it goes to another male, it goes to another male. So whatever gene is present on the Y chromosome, we can see they move from male to male, male to male, male to male, like that. The genes which are present on the Y chromosome are also known as cholandric genes. For example, you know, some people, they are having hairs on their ear pinnae. Ear pinnae matlab external ear. Generally, this is seen in males. So from father to son, son to grandson, again to grandson, it goes like that. So no confusion regarding Y chromosomal inheritance. Genes on X chromosome, we call it as X-linked genes. Well, you know, in the case of females, they have two X chromosomes. If I take any gene present on this X chromosome, there will be a counterpart, another allele on the another X chromosomes. As usual, through the laws of inheritance and all, two alleles now present on this homologous chromosome. That means alleles may have again a relationship of dominance and recessiveness. Majority of
diseases are
controlled by recessive genes. Inheritances such as color blindness, hemophilia, sickle cell anemia. Such diseases are actually controlled by recessive gene of X chromosome. Let us take one individual which is normal male. He is marrying a normal female. Here it is XY, normal female, XX. They will have again 50% of chance to form a female child as well as 50% of chance to form a male child. Take all the possibilities. We will take this X chromosome and this X chromosome separately. There will be a male who is formed by combination of these two. You can have another male which is having the combination of these two. In the case of X also, they can have two combinations. One is the combination between these two X's, and the other combination will be of these two X's. All these possibilities, a normal male and normal female, do not have any chance of forming a diseased individual. Let's take a condition where normal man to a normal female. What we are getting here is, we are getting a diseased son. Char possibility hai, usme se ek mein disease aane ka chance 25% hai. That means there are some diseased gene on this X chromosome. Why do we confirm this as X chromosome? Because we have seen the father is normal. If father is normal and son is diseased, अगर फादर के वाई क्रोमोसोम में है तो सन को ऑब्वियसली डिजीज होना चाहिए. अगर ये फादर से आया है तो ये फादर डिजीज होना चाहिए. बट हियर वी सी फादर इज नॉर्मल एंड डिजीज इज सीन ओनली इन सन. सो द कंडीशन इज ये एक्स क्रोमोसोम से रिलेटेड डिजीज होगा और आया होगा कहाँ से? मदर से. सन्स दे आर गेटिंग एक्स क्रोमोसोम फ्रॉम मदर. The condition of mother here, the mother may be a diseased woman, but not able to understand the diseasedness because the disease gene is present in heterozygous condition. एक X chromosome में recessive gene है, दूसरे X chromosome में recessive gene नहीं है, मतलब dominant gene है. Phenotype of this individual will be normal.
But the son who receives X chromosome from mother will have the disease. Just recall this condition. We know X and Y.
X chromosome में अगर वो diseased gene रहेगा, उसके counterpart कहाँ नहीं होगा? Y chromosome में नहीं हो सकता है.
So the individual is diseased. This condition is also known as hemizygous condition.
Let us take the example of female. The X chromosome can one of the females, but females are found to be normal because they are getting another pair of another X chromosome from the father, which seems to be having a dominant allele. So again, this daughter will be found to be normal, but the daughter is carrying one X chromosome with a diseased allele. Such females are known as carriers. We call that females as carriers. So here mother is a carrier and this type of daughter जो बनेगा वो भी एक carrier है. Whereas ये है normal son, this is a again normal, fully normal daughter.
Here is the cross between a normal man and a carrier mother will result in 25% of normal daughter, 25% of carrier daughter, 25% normal son and 25% diseased son. Thank you all. Have a good day.